we were off to the Narragansett side of the Narrow River to visit one of the ocean state's most significant, if less well-known, ocean resources.
The group of people here are very dynamic, and they do everything from ocean exploration to ocean economics and everything in between.
A biological oceanographer, Paula Bontempi, is dean of the University of Rhode Island's Graduate School of Oceanography. An alum herself, she came back to URI after more than a decade at NASA. Yes, NASA.
It's nothing for me to be sitting on a plane and sit next to someone in those years and they say, what do you do? And I say, I'm an oceanographer. And they say, where do you work? And I say, NASA. And they look at me like I have six heads.
Bontempi's work at NASA was part of its research into the Earth's atmosphere, including its oceans. That's now her entire focus at the Graduate School of Oceanography.
We cover pole to pole in our research and a lot of our academic programs. We also are very, very focused on coastal zones where land meets water, what's happening now with climate change, with sea level rise, and how that impacts not just the United States, but the world, and especially here at home in Rhode Island.
The GSO, as it's known, has humble beginnings here going back to the late 19th century. Growing in earnest by the late 1950s, today it occupies a 153-acre campus on Narragansett Bay, draws students from around the world, most of whom pursue a 2 to 3 year Master of Science program.
The students know their place in the world. They see themselves as global citizens, so they're thinking more about what are the grand challenges of our time. Is it climate change? Is it renewable energy? Is it coastal resilience? And what is my role and how do I help?
Michelle Hauer is a fifth-year doctoral student in biological oceanography.
Have you ever gone out on the research ship, the Endeavor?
Yes, I've gone on one Endeavor cruise.
How was that?
It was great. I mean, the one on the Endeavor was short and sweet. But our most recent cruise was 2 months long.
Not surprisingly, the changing climate's impact on oceans is a galvanizing issue here.
Rhode Island is the ocean state. We have 413 miles of coastline and 7,000 properties and businesses located along that coastline. So how is that going to be impacted as the climate changes?
So the issue of rising sea levels is definitely a key part of research for oceanography today.
It is. Sea level rise, what's driving it, and what the impacts are.
Investment in that research is highlighted by the recent opening of a brand new $45 million pier for the Narragansett campus, which allows for the replacement in turn of the school's 47-year-old research vessel Endeavor. The Narragansett Dawn is expected to be berthed here by early 2025.
It is a state-of-the-art research vessel designed to usher in the next generation of ocean exploration, research, and science, and test out a lot of new technology.
But even with its global reach, much research here at URI remains locally focused.
What are you looking for?
So this sample is from bacteria, and we're testing the bacteria that the state uses to determine if it's safe to swim, and also if it's safe to shellfish.
Marine biologist and URI professor Elizabeth Herron heads the 30-year-old Watershed Watch program, which uses a network of volunteers across Rhode Island, including our friend Veronica Baranski on the Narrow River, to regularly monitor all of the state's salt and freshwater, which is then tested and analyzed at URI. For Herron, it's science and civic engagement at its best.
I've wanted to be a scientist since I was probably 8 years old. I didn't know what that meant then, but as I got older, I realized that science is, in addition to being really amazing and interesting, if it can be used to help people and help our environment, that's really important, and this program allows me to do that.
Locally, globally, a focus on our water in the most fitting place of all, in the heart of the ocean state.
And you heard Ted mention that Paula Bontempi, the
yes.
dean at the Graduate School of Oceanography at URI, previously worked at NASA.
Yeah, and she also recently served on what's known as NASA's UFO commission. She did not share any of her findings with Ted, no surprise there. So we're just going to have to wait for the official study to be released, which could be as early as the end of this month.
A lot of people are waiting to see that. Up next, summer nights at the ball field.